Hi, I'm Max, your virtual assistant for Sonarworks software. This video tutorial will highlight the DADman profile export for AVID MTRX and DADman family interfaces with SPQ processing. Note that your speakers will have to be remeasured as the new export feature will be using the DADman profile during the speaker measurements. To get started, launch the DADman and the SoundID Reference Measure applications. Click on Get Started and select your speaker configuration. We will be using a 7.1.4 speaker setup. Then tick the checkbox below to let the Measure app know you are using an AVID MTRX or DAD family interface. This will allow the DADman profile to be used during the measurements. Go through the setup checklist, making sure that everything is ready for the measurement process. Note that the majority of the steps are still the same for all devices used, so we will skip over some parts and focus on the steps required for AVID MTRX and DADman devices specifically. If you need assistance with the general speaker measurement process, visit the speaker measurement guides linked below. During the next step in the hardware setup stage, we'll need to load our current DADman profile in the Measure app. Click on the Browse button, locate your current DADman profile that is used inside the DADman app. Select the DIMPROF file and click Open to load it into the Measure app. Your DADman profile may have multiple output groups. Please select the one that has your speaker setup. Click on the Output Group Container dropdown to select your output group. For us, the output group is called Monitor. Then we confirm the group to measure based on the group container. SoundID Reference will now create a copy DADman profile, which will be used throughout the measurement process. The new DADman profile will always have Sonarworks mentioned in the file name for ease of access. With the new file created, access the DADman app to load the newly created profile. You will notice that the new profile will be placed as a second output item and will be highlighted in blue, showing that it is active. Let's go back to the Measure app and confirm we've executed these steps. Click Yes, my profile is loaded, and Yes, my output is set to proceed. We can now proceed as normal through the hardware setup and the rest of the measurement stages, as there are no additional steps required for DADman specifically. During the results overview, you can see each channel that has been measured and check each channel's frequency response, level difference, and delay. Click on the Save and Finish button to name your Sonarworks calibration profile and save it to your computer. Measure app will offer to use our newly created profile. We will proceed with opening the SoundID Reference app to export the calibration profile. With the SoundID Reference app open, we can close the Measure app as it's no longer needed. Go back to the Reference app and click on Add New Output. Our device in use is the DADman Virtual Sound Card. With our output device added as a preset, load the Sonarworks calibration profile. Click on the Select Your Calibration Profile dropdown and select your speaker calibration profile from recent items. Before proceeding to the export stage, SoundID Reference can be used to select different target mode, or we can adjust some of the features such as listening spot or limit controls. The newly selected parameters will be applied to the calibration preset export. If you're going through the process for the first time, we recommend keeping the default settings, flat target and all the DSP features enabled as is. Click on the calibration preset 3-dot button and select the export option. Next, select your device from the list of supported devices. We have been using AVID MTRX Studio. Make sure to select the DADman profile file option during the export file prompt. Close the DADman app before moving to the next step, as the Sonarworks calibration profile will be applied to the DADman profile. Load the modified DADman DIMPROF file you have used during the measurement process. Remember that the file used during the measurement process will have Sonarworks in the name. Lastly, select the group container in which to create the calibrated speaker group. Our container group was called Monitor. Once confirmed, click Export for the Reference app to export the preset. It can take up to 2 minutes to export the calibration preset. We can now fully quit the SoundID Reference application and load the DADman app. The calibration preset export is applied to the DADman profile once the DADman app is relaunched. You're welcome to expand the EQ option to see the correction for each channel. If you encounter an issue during the process, go to the SoundID Reference Support page and search for the error code title or description. Likely, the issue is already documented with a solution available. Subscribe to our channel for more support videos. Thanks for watching.